Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 25 of FTB Interactions, where today I'm processing sapphire. Between episodes, we mined a bunch of sapphire ore. I did find, if we look on the map, up here, if you look in the quests, let's go back that far, we will see a note that says the Ordo, I think it's around here, and sapphire veins spawn in cold biomes only. Haha, that was a good hint. So I ran across my little land bridge up there on my map. Ran straight across. And literally right by the Astral Temple, I found a sapphire vein. I think I had found it before and just forgot to mark it. And that probably explains why I had a few sapphires laying around. But green sapphire is also found in another vein type. I don't even know anymore, dudes. I don't even know. And I did decide, you know what? Let's go ahead and do the steam macerator piece. Here's the math, right? You get 5 nuggets per dust, right? So 9 nuggets is an ingot. So almost, if you double it with the macerator, you get almost, technically a little bit more than, 1 ingot per ore, right? So you get a stack of sapphire ore. That's a stack of aluminum dust or ingots, right? If you don't macerate it, it's half. So might as well just double it. And that's what I did. Yeah. And also, if you factor in that you get tiny piles of green sapphire dust when you centrifuge your sapphire dust. So like you basically get 1 1/3 dusts. So like you really get a lot more aluminum. So I think it's the right call to be doing it. It takes longer, but since I have it mostly automated, it's less of a problem. And look, I also set this up because 4 inventory slots, like I walked away to mine and came back and it was full. And I was like, oh, duh. Like it's making 2 different resources, right? So what we'll do then is aluminum. Yay. Hooray, hooray. And I think what I'm going to do real quick. So I'm not entirely sure what the best path of progression at this point is. Like I'd like to break into MV stuff. And I suspect I'm pretty soon going to need to be doing some Batania and some Astral and some Thalmcraft. I just don't know how much and how bad I need to start looking at that, right? But hey, Mana Steel cables, that looks interesting because they have loss per block 0. So that's a pretty good indication that Mana Steel is going to be your lossless cable for MV tier. Good to know. Good to know. That is cool beans, right? And it's Mana Steel wire, which is your standard wire mill process. Yes, and it works at LV tier, so we're not worried about that. We're also going to need some silicone rubber to make that happen, or some rubber, or some rubber, or some rubber, or styrene butadiene rubber, or yeah, I don't know like any of this stuff. But long story short, rubber is a thing that we need to consider, right? Rubber or silicone rubber. And I assume, like, we know how to make rubber, right? We've already been doing that. It's this. So we know how to make rubber. We can probably work on that, you know. I think we have more chemical reactors because when I made my chemical reactors, I got 2 basic chemical reactors as a reward, right? So that's cool. So we've got a couple extra of those. And there's also a whole quest line about chemistry for LV tier. Like, a really big quest line. Hydrogen and all this other stuff. Chlorine and I don't even know, but it sounds cool. Look, we're not going to require you to bucket out this useless chemical because it's such an annoying quest book practice. That's funny. Nice. All right. Getting salty. Oh, yeah, the thermal evaporation stuff. Ooh, and we'll get a fluid transfer node. Wireless transmission of fluid from cyclic. Oh my goodness, there's so many quests and so many things. Like, I don't even know. This is part of the problem with me not knowing Greg Tech all that well. I don't know, like, the right way to progress, right? Like, I don't know what I should be working on, and I'm just kind of winging it. And I hope it's leading to entertaining content for you guys. I really do. Like, feel free, put some comments on this video. I want to know. Like, are you guys enjoying the series? Are you enjoying, like, me not entirely knowing? Because half the time I get comments like, Dire, we want to see you do something new. But then a lot of times when I do something new, I'm not an expert at it. And people are like, Dire, it's painful to watch you not know everything. So I understand that there's a healthy balance there between working with mods I've worked with 1,000 times before and therefore know perfectly versus not. So hopefully that's all right. But let's progress down the MV machine hull tier. And I think what we'll do progression-wise, we'll look at getting some MV steam boilers. And then some MV batteries, and then probably the MV to LV converter thingy so that we can still power our LV machines and not blow them up, because blowing things up is bad. And then probably the MV battery block and all that stuff too. So yeah, that's kind of where we're going to start. And then we will probably be branching out into Batania and Astral, because there's a lot of cool things we can do in Astral. We can get like ore quintupling pretty easily, I think, in Astral. I don't know how much of Astral has been changed, but the fact that we got this so early tells me definitely some stuff has, right? So that's cool, right? And I don't have any idea what we're going to do with these tiny piles of dark ashes, but I'm assuming they're used for something. Block of ashes. You can package them. Seems... ashes and carbon dust. I mean, it's all right. We'll figure it out. At some point, something will happen. I have my philosopher's stone because I was doing more melting of ingots and whatnot. Let's go. I'm going to go teach this thing how to make MV wires and machine holes, right? So an MV machine hole is what we need to make. So we need an MV casing, which is an assembler Mark 8, so that's easy. And then in addition, we're going to need copper cables. Do we know how to make the copper cables yet? So that one, copper cables requires silicon rubber or rubber, right? What's silicon rubber by chance? Fluid extractor of silicon rubber ingots or polydimethylis... what dust? That stuff. C2H6OSI. Yeah. I don't think we're quite there yet. So probably... and styrene butadiene rubber, I got to imagine, is even more complex, right? It's raw styrene butadiene rubber dust, which is, you know, all kinds of things. So that is not happening either. And then your other option is rubber, right? Or we could use small pile and less rubber, but I think the 144 millibuckets of rubber is what's going to be up, right? So what we should probably do, here's what my thought process is for automating the rubber. Because we're going to need this for both the MV machine tier stuff and the mana steel stuff, right? So to automate this, what we should do is we should throw a chemical reactor down here and basically, like, active request pipe, some sulfur and raw rubber pulp, and keep them full. And then we can process raw rubber pulp as an extractor. We could probably get like an LV extractor or something like that. Is there an LV tier of extractor? There is. So we can do a basic extractor, right? And we can have the sticky resin. We can just have like a bunch of it because that's really easy to get. We just grow some rubber trees and chop them down and we get sticky resin right away. So the raw rubber pulp is easy. Sulfur, also relatively easy. We should have a decent amount of sulfur. From processing all the coal that I've been doing. So if we check in here, we will find that we have a decent amount of sulfur dust, right? So that'll get us started at least. I think that's a good idea. Let's do that. So what we're gonna want is we're going to want our, and then we're gonna wanna add that to, how do we do the copper wires? What machine does it made in? It's made in assembler. So an assembler with rubber. So what we're gonna want is an assembler LV, right? And then we're gonna want a chemical reactor LV, which we should have one of. We should have two of, actually, because that was a quest reward. Cool. So there's your chemical reactor LV. And then to make the rubber, which we've been doing a little bit manually up here, but you get the idea. But rubber is made with raw rubber pulp, which needs an extractor. Is your best bet, right? I think that's true. Extractor seems to be your best bet. So we're gonna want an LV extractor. And then we're gonna want sulfur dust, which we currently have some of. And I'd love to find a better way to get sulfur dust besides just, you know, processing coal. But I'm sure that we can, you know, find a way. Sulfur dust, lead zinc solution. That's right. We've been getting tiny piles for the most part. So like silver, lead, sulfur. There's actually a lot of things that seem to do it. But it's mostly silver lead. Okay, maybe it was silver and lead. It wasn't coal. Coal gives me something else as a byproduct. That's right. Infernal deconglomerator. That's cool. That's kind of cool. And it uses mana. I'm really interested to see some, like we've been very heavily focused on logistics pipes and Greg Tech lately and teching up through there. But I'm super excited to see, like, where this all goes, right? Like, where does everything flesh out? I'm very curious to see how it all works out. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Anyway, to work. So we're going to want the centrifuge, right? Basic extractor for that. And we should be cool. All right. Back in a minute when I get all these things ready to go. All right, guys, I want to show you this on camera because it keeps happening, and I want to show you how this works. So the crafting buffer upgrade, we're going to upgrade this thing. So this packager keeps happening where, like, the red wire and the tin wire keep colliding and getting stuck, and it's annoying me. And even though we're probably moving away from using this soon, I still want to fix it on camera with you guys so you can see what the process looks like, right? So we've just broken it, right? And we've got some crafting modules, right? So we're going to, just like we did with, well, basically we don't need the chest, right? We can have a satellite pipe here. Boop. And you're going to be packager one, okay? And then we can have an unrouted logistics pipe and a crafting manager. Technically, we don't need the unrouted, right? And into you will go the two crafting modules, right? One for tin, one for red, right? But then also we add in here the chest crafting buffer upgrade thing. And here is where the chest goes. And this can be either type of chest. It doesn't have to be the slightly larger one. Doesn't matter, right? And then you're good. Because this keeps happening, and like I said, super annoying. And then we want the result logistics pipe here, and your name will be... No, not assembler one. Packager one, right? Packager one. There you go. Packager one, packager one. And we can use unrouteds, by the way, because unrouteds, if you guys didn't know this, don't connect to machines. See? Look there. The unrouteds don't connect to machines. So we don't have to worry about these being unrouted and being at junctions because unrouteds do not connect to machines. How cool beans is that? Love it. And then the last note here is, again, you should be selected as packager one. You should be selected as packager one. And now we hopefully won't have any more collisions, right? And we'll see if that's true going forward. So we've got, oh, and don't forget, we need this with the screwdriver and the wrench thing. So you're going to come over here. You're going to go into the, well, we don't actually need that because, yeah, we don't need that here either. We can probably remove that even. I forget how. I think it's the crowbar that you can use to remove that. Is crowbar a thing? Wow, that's a lot of stuff, isn't it? Can we have, what do we got? Steel? I could do steel rods. Yeah, we'll do steel. And then the file and the hammer. And you guys can go back. And you're making steel rods, which shouldn't be too bad. Yeah, it just occurred to me that, like, I don't need that no more. Am I missing something? Why you no craft? Oh, right. I forgot the four lapis. There you go. I was missing something. And I think crowbar is how you get... Can I do it there? Haha! Don't need that no more. Nice. See? Already saving stuff. Beautiful. All right, so we've got our basic assembly machine that's going to be doing this. And we've got the chemical reactor to make the rubber. So these two are going to be the make rubber, use rubber. And then finally, we just need the extractor that'll turn resin into stuff. So where are we at with these components? We're missing six paper. It's my villager voice. Wow, we are low on EMC. I think I know where I can go get some EMC at. I'm going to go mine some obsidian is what I'm going to do. And that should get me lots of EMC. But in the meantime, let's rapidly solve this problem, right? So you go in here with shears. And then I put these in here, and they should go poof, poof. Nice. And then when they convert, they'll land in here as paper. Nice, right? All right, let me go find some obsidian. Do we have anywhere on the map that, like, lava's on the surface? That looks like lava right there. And I feel like I could make that run to that village, right? Yeah, and we'll bring... this dude, and we'll mine up some obsidian, and that'll be a win. By the way, did I mention I planted sugarcane at some point? I did. Did I also mention sugarcane is like the mod that lets sugarcane grow forever? Yeah, I'm just saying. Just saying. I think there's a faster way to convert sugarcane into paper at some point in the future, but we'll get there, right? I was kind of planning ahead. There's a lot of planning ahead in Greg Tech. Did you notice? All right, back in a few. All right, just turned a bunch of lava into obsidian. Now we get lots of EMC. All right, back home, we've got paper, and we've got 63 obsidian. Oh, look at all the EMC. That's how you farm EMC, folks. All right, back to this thing in which we request this, and we get everything we need for the extractor. So we're gonna get rubber production automated, then we're going to get into MV production and get that automated. Oh, and as an FYI, I think we've got, see things buffering up here and it not sending it to the chest until it's got everything it needs. How cool is that? Look at that go, huh? How cool is that? That is awesome right there. See it buffering in the chest? That thing is awesome. And I think you might still occasionally get a collision here and there, but maybe not, we'll see. And even if you do, I've noticed that it's good about dealing with it after the fact. How cool is that? Perfect, perfect, awesome. Yeah, I think there was a collision, because see how it went directly in there? That tells me that there was a collision, but this thing was smart about the collision and made it so that it worked. So I'm gonna 10 out of 10, that is amazing. I love it. And hey, look, basic extractor, cool. All right, so where do we want this layout to be? Like, do we wanna keep expanding out sideways here, or like, how do we wanna do this? I think so. All my routing's done, right? So let's get the 4X cabling that we need. And we're probably gonna want some chassis pipes, right? So like, let's get a couple of chassis ones, and we're gonna want, I've got a chassis 4, right? Let's get a couple more of these. And let's get some 4X cables. We might need a couple more of these. Shouldn't be too big of a deal though. Yeah, I think we need at least one more. So do we have, how are we for blue steel? We've got 4 of them. That'll turn into my 3, right? And that's enough for the 3 new machines that we have. So let's get this going, right? So unrouteds go away, all this stuff. Right. Perfect. So first things first, right? We want our basic extractor, and you're going to have some logic to go here, right? So you're going to get a satellite pipe. You know, let's do this with a logistics chassis Mark IV, because I don't think we're going to have a lot of things in the extractor yet, right? Oh, that's right. I needed to make new cards, didn't I? Let's get that happening really fast. Let's get you and you back together. And I'll be back in a minute after I make new cards. All right, auto crafting modules, hooray. And as a reminder, you get 8 at a time for this. So that's awesome. Okay, so you turn into crafting component cards and now we can get that going again. And by the way, I had to salvage a Cooper nickel so I could get that automated. So I better reprogram that. Okay, so you were going to do a crafting card within which you say we were gonna get rubber, right? So we're adding that, we're removing these things because we did all this, right? So we're working on rubber at this point. So you need raw rubber pulp. And an extractor is one sticky resin makes 4 raw rubber pulp, right? So 4 raw rubber pulp from a sticky resin. Okay, easy peasy. And then next up, right, and you need cabling, by the way, all 3 of you. Next up, we're going to have the basic chemical reactor, right? And your job, we're going to want a module that's like an active request module, I think it's called. Isn't that what we want? Active supplier module. I knew it was active something. And you can probably be a basic logistics pipe. And you're gonna get the active supplier module and items to keep stocked. We'll do bulk 50. So we're gonna say, in order to make rubber in this thing, let's say keep, let's do 5X. No, let's do 4X. So 4 and 36 raw rubber pulp and 4 sulfur, right? So 4 sulfur dust. And ...36 raw rubber, right? And look at that, it already did the sulfur dust and it's already processing the raw rubber for me. Nice, cool. Look at that, it's keeping it in stock. Perfect, that's what we wanted. So see the active supplier, right? That's exactly what it does. It says, I'm going to request and keep these items in stock all the time. And he'll do his best, right? Now, we don't have a way to craft sulfur automatically yet, and we're probably gonna run out of resin at some point, but that's okay. We'll get there. Okay. Now we want to pump. So give me one of those electric pumps. I crafted them in bulk a couple episodes back. I don't know that we have these automated yet, but they're like kind of a hassle. Like, oh my goodness, look at all these things. Look at all this. This is terrible. I haven't automated them yet because I just made a bunch of them off camera and it was a hassle, and I'm hoping we don't need them much longer. But you pump out the side into a basic assembly machine, which is now getting all the rubber. Now this stores 64,000 rubber, which is a lot. So we're gonna use a lot to fill up the backlog of this. And we ran into this in Omnifactory too. And it's like, well, it is what it is, right? It stinks, but it is what it is. Because you're gonna have a large 64 buffer and you're gonna have a large 64K. So we're gonna have 128 buckets of rubber here, just sitting here. I don't know if there's a way to prevent that. I'm assuming there isn't. There might be a way, but it's probably meh. But then you, sir, didn't I get some extra big Mark IV chassis dudes? Did I leave them in here? I totally did. Right. Now your job as an advanced logistics chassis pipe will be to come in here, and this is where we're going to teach it two things. One, you're going to get, so for MV, MV machine hulls, which is what we want, right? We're going to want 1X copper cable, right? So your job as 1X copper cable, it's just one-to-one, right? So literally you put 1X copper cable in here with program circuit 24, rubber is 24, right? So that's it, right? So one-to-one. And then for this guy, please tell me this is also 24. It is. Thank you. Thank you for not making me do two machines for this, because I would have raged. There would have been dire rage, okay? But now you to you, and I'm pretty sure we already know how to make copper cable in our doohickey. This is our wire mill. Right, so we've got copper cable on the thing, but we should probably teach him, even though we don't have Man of Steel yet, we should probably still teach him that 2X Man of Steel is, yeah. Okay, so now, right, and then your MV machine hole is an assembler or just a regular crafting. I'm thinking assembler is how we'll do it. It's the same either way. Let's not forget our circuit for 24. And as a reminder, these things are super, like, it's just any one of these circuits. The integrated logic circuits is fine, right? You need to go in here, assembly machine. And then over here, we will say MV machine holes is two MVs, or one MV casing and two copper wires, right? So MV casing for an MV machine hole, 1X copper wire times two. And then in addition to that, we want you to know how to make MV machine holes casings, which is just 8X and circuit 8, which is the one we're in, right? So 8X aluminum plates. Sweet. And now we should be able to request, you ready for this? An MV machine hole. Missing 8X aluminum plates. I didn't teach you that yet. Hold on. So then, you know, we need is more. Let me get ...16 of these for fine electrum wire. Two fine electrum wire. Well, we have electrum ingots. So we'll make these by hand real quick. And then that'll be fine. And then we'll teach the system how to make fine electrum wire at some point. But I don't have any more crafting cards to do it right now. So sort module, how about 24 of these? Ta-da, item sync modules ready to roll. See, look at everything buffer into the chests above. That's the thing that's super cool. Back in a few. Dude, I love it when auto crafting works. Like, it's just the best. It is literally the best. All right, so everything's good now, right? We needed, what were we missing for the MV machine hole? Oh, right, aluminum plates. So that'll be your plate bending machine, right? So we're just gonna throw aluminum plates in here for aluminum ingots. And I'm just assuming that this will work, right? So let's complete our quest. MV machine hole request. Booyah. And all the things should happen properly. So you're gonna do the thing. You're making plates, you're making wires. The wires are gonna route their way over to here. They're gonna get wrapped with rubber. 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 What am I missing here? I thought rubber, did I miss something? Where, no, this one, rubber, yes. 144 millibuckets of rubber and a 1X copper wire needs program circuit 24. Did I not make you 24? I didn't make you 24. Dire, please. Now it's working. Now it's working. Good gerb. Dire, please. With all the derps. And then you're assembling the MV machine hull. And that, my friends, is a quest complete. I think the biggest part of this series will be to automate all the things. Hey, look, we got a lot of quests completes for that. So we got another MV machine hole. Hooray. And we get an achievement, which gives us a medium voltage reward and some circuits and some more MV machine holes. Yay. Once you're into MV, your next materials goal will be producing stainless at HV power. See the metallurgy and AYO technology tabs for related tier information. You're also going to need more power. A good option is diesel, which you can enrich with canola to double or more your oil input, as well as enrich further in HV to cetane boosted and eventually infused. The idea of a non-renewable resource may not sit well with you, but we've got the tools in this pack for you to stretch it very far. A single well will last you days before you need to move your pump, and eventually the Narrowmatic Prime, that's from Astral, will last a week or more before you simply move it to another chunk over. The fuel stays applicable even at endgame with the most powerful fuel in the game, Naquadriatic Fuel. Wow, that sounds fun. So a little pat on the back for us. My rewards, I should really place like a rewards thing somewhere because I've got all these rewards that I got. Should do something with them. You can go in here, and we've also got, man, we got a lot of MV machine holes for that quest reward. How cool is that? Nice. Sort away my cobble. Did I mention that I set up down here a quick cobble drawer that's voiding? I filled it up with EMC, which is why we were low on EMC earlier. But I wanted, like, basically a lot of cobble, and that's why we have 4K cobble sitting here. And we've got our wood available as well. Are you still cooking? You are, and you're doing a just a splendiferous job. Sapphire, 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 sapphire. Good times. Just keep on keeping on, buddy. You are just processing, and that is fine by me. And you've probably got a lot of stuff sitting around, too. A lot of impure sapphire dusts. Nice. Get you into there. Just keep on keeping on, everybody. All right, back in a few once I plan my next moves. All right, guys, so I've got good news. I think we can make a building gadget soon. And the reason I'm looking at doing this, and I'm curious to see if this thing's chargeable. I don't know if it's chargeable. Like, I didn't make it so that it's chargeable with Greg Tech power, I believe. I think it just uses forge energy. So if this doesn't easily convert to forge energy, no luck. But there's probably a way to charge the building gadget. Can I just, like, make it now? Is there anything I'm missing? Wouldn't hurt, right? I just need a battery. It's enriched alloy. Which we've made before, right? Assembler. Oh. Have we not made this? I thought we made this. Did I get it as a quest reward? I got it as a quest reward, didn't I? Yeah, I don't think we've made this yet. Soldering alloy and graphite dust and destabilized redstone. That's probably something for the manual crafting thing, because I don't know how many of those we'll need. But we should probably have a... See, like, we have a lot of things. Like, fluid extractor is where we get redstone, right? Melter or fluid extractor? Yes. Fluid extractor, redstone dust will give me the destabilized redstone. So I can get the destabilized redstone that we need for that. And then the soldering alloy, I think that we have, right? Don't we have soldering alloy? We have some. And I know we got that as a quest reward too. And then we get that. Okay, cool. So we can pull that off. And the sodium battery, obviously, we've made, right? Small battery hole. Yeah, let's do that real quick. I would love to have one of these. I want to test it out real fast. And that shouldn't be a problem, right? Yeah, tin cable's cooking. Nice. I like it, like it, like it. Come on, tin cable, let's go. There you are. On your way. I presume. There it is, finally. Okay, and then you go into the canning machine to make a battery. Sweet. Okay. Now, the other thing we need is a assembler, right? An LV assembler. So let's add you, and I'm going to craft the things we need here. I need 4 steel ingots. Oh, we're low on steel again, and 2 robot arms. All right. Yeah, we're just low on steel. I got a coal dust and iron. I can pull that off real quick. 2 of you and 2 of you. And tick accelerate it. And we'll be back in a sec once this is done. See? I don't even know. Anyway, it's like super quick, isn't it? The power of having that infinite steel, though, huh? That's why I kept the steel machines around. You can't do that with LV machines. Steel machines, you can do that too. Right? Steel machines, you can do that too. Not LV machines. I'll tell you, just watching the status over here of this, all this stuff crafting is just so satisfying to me. I don't know why. I love spending like a few episodes building a giant automation process and then being able to say, I want one of these, and it just happens. Like, granted, there's some things that we didn't have ready, right? Like the steel and whatnot. I've been making steel in bulk. Frankly, I could teach, and I had to go get more black carpet because that we're always running out too. I could teach steel at this point to the system. I just haven't yet, right? But then we're going to remove, let's remove you. And we're going to replace you with this, right? And then if we want an enriched alloy, right? So we want a building gadget, because fun, right? So to make an enriched alloy, and you're going to go in there, we need a soldering alloy ingot, graphite, and 2 redstone. So 2 redstone, soldering alloy ingot, and graphite dust. Not 2, I just double-clicked by mistake. Cool, and then you go in there, and then you 2 go in there, and I don't know if you need a programming card, I didn't look. You do not. Hooray! We did the thing. That was easy enough. And that'll get me these. That's right, I remember now. We got some of these for a quest, right? The basic steam turbine, and we also got some for basic mechanical pipes. Yeah. So I knew I needed them, and we got them from a quest. That's right. I remember now. And then you're going to go up here, Mr. Basic Fluid Solidifier, and this will basically be our interchangeable when we need to manually craft a one-off thing, right? If we get to the point where we need these in bulk, obviously I'll do something like I just did for rubber and cabling, but yeah, that's what's up. So you're going to get me my alloy. La-di-di-da. And then get me the rest of the things I need. Beautiful. 2 ender pearls. Yeah, we may have to get more Enderman killing happening. Somebody mentioned a quest for killing Enderman? I totally killed Enderman, right? Somebody's like, you get a really OP sword if you kill an Enderman. And I was like, oh? Because I killed Enderman. I don't even know, dude. We should look into chickens, too, at some point. Because I bet there's some chickens that would be useful for us at this point. But I don't even know. Look, it's a building gadget. Quest complete. The dire gadgets. It was a quest? That's awesome. Yay, there's a quest for me and my stuff. Construction block powder. And charge pad from Mechanism. Would you look at that? Building gadgets offers a variety of utility items to aid in building, importing, and exporting structures and removing structures. Make sure to check out the linked mod spotlight by the man himself, DW20. That's me! Hint, you may be able to find some of the multi-blocks in this pack as schematics to save you some building time. The charge pad reward will charge any RF items in your hotbar when provided RF power. Really? That is cool beans. Now we have a thing here that's providing RF power, but we're gonna need to do it. So that's an CEULV. It might be easier to make another one of those. CEULV right now. CEULV. Yeah, it seems like really easy to make, right? Missing four paper, because of course we are. How are we missing paper again? Oh my goodness. With the things and the stuff and the saplings. To do more of that. I don't think we have any more flints in here, right? No more flint dudes? Yeah, we'll have to take care of that. But that should get us a few more pieces of paper. I just really want to knock this out before we wrap up the episode. Here's what I'm thinking while we're waiting for this. I want you guys to know my thought process. Next episode, my thoughts are we will get into Batania and Astral. I'd like to start getting away from Greg because I feel like, and again, leave comments. Let me know how you guys are feeling. But I feel like maybe people are a little like, you've been doing a lot of the same thing for a while. I'd like to avoid that. So like if we got away from Greg, that might be cool. And what we can do, oh, it's just so satisfying. And look, there's like black carpet just chilling there waiting for us to have enough, and then it comes in. That is a really, really useful upgrade. I'm telling you guys, I can't overstate how important that is. But I feel like maybe some people are like, yeah, we've seen a lot of Greg lately. Let's see some other stuff. So maybe playing with some other mods, see what changes were made to things like Astral and Batania. There's some really powerful stuff in Astral, as you guys may or may not recall. Batania as well. Batania has some really powerful things, so I'd like to get them. Like, I'd love a sash and all that stuff to make me run faster. But for now, like I said, we'll see. But let's just see how this EU charge pad thing works out, and then we'll be cool, right? So it's all making its way up. We're doing the thing, right? It's silly of me to not just, but you know what I'm doing, right? I'm being lazy, right? A smart person would just be like, hey, but this will charge up anything in my hotbar, it said, right? Hooray! Look, it's charging. Nice. So, he presumably won't charge in here. Yeah, look, he don't even click into there. But yeah, that's awesome. All right, wrapping up point. Darryl with my son off. There's a reason I made building gadgets right before we got into Batania. You guys may know what it is. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Take it easy.